Hi, it's David Olson again. I don't know if you guys watched the first segment or if you're just jumping in on this segment. Thank you for watching it regardless though. I'm just gonna talk a little bit about some of the things that we're working on. The last segment that I had done, we talked a little bit about El Hazard, which is one of the other projects we're working on. But the thing that we're working on, at least a lot more currently, and trying to get completed at least in a little bit more of a hasty sense, is the Tylor stuff for the Tylor Ultra set. The Tylor Ultra set, if you know anything about it, it's for the Irresponsible Captain Tylor. We're doing a TV and OVA Blu-ray collection. It'll come in a box with a book and an extras disc and a number of other things. The video work and the audio work and most of the authoring work in terms of making the Blu-rays and everything is complete at this point. What I've been primarily working on, at least in regards to Tylor, is I've been trying to put together the extras for the extras disc. One of the things that we had gotten in all of the, I don't know if you want to call them tiers, but the stretch goals, at least for the sales on the set, we're adding content bonuses to the Tylor Ultra, release. And one of the things, at least, that was added as part of the upper tier stretch goals was trying to get in some interviews with staff and cast and that type of thing. We have interviews with Hitoshi Yoshioka, who is the original creator and the author for The Irresponsible Captain Tylor. We have an interview with Kenji Kawai, who did some music, particularly for the OVA series. He's a really well-known film and TV composer. And then we also have interviews with three of the main voice actors from The Irresponsible Captain Tylor. That's Crispin Freeman, who plays Tylor himself, Lisa Ortiz, who plays Ozalin and the Hanner twins. And then we also have an interview with David Brimmer, who plays Lieutenant Yamamoto. So one of the other things that we're looking to also include in the extras disc that we haven't really talked about, mainly because it was something that we weren't even aware was available or existing, I guess you could say, was we're looking to put together a auditions reel of sorts for all of the different actors and people who were auditioning for Irresponsible Captain Tylor back in the late 90s. The original translator on Irresponsible Captain Tylor, Neil Nadelman, he actually had tapes of the original auditions back when they were recorded, and he was able to get us these tapes and get us copies of these tapes, and we could get the files off of the tapes. So we actually have original audio files of the original auditions for the show, which is really interesting because you'll hear certain actors recording and doing lines and reads for different characters that they may not have ended up getting cast for. Or you might hear certain actors doing reads for a character, but doing it in a tone or with a certain amount of inflection that they might not have used in the final recording. And it's actually really interesting to kind of see what their original interpretation of the character was based off of the little information that was made available to them. And then kind of seeing these in comparison to where the show ended up and in the end. And it's actually very interesting too, because there are many people in the show who were, you know, cast in other roles, but they did reads for other characters. So you'll hear, like, one of the examples is you'll hear Crispin Freeman. He was cast as Tylor, of course, but you'll actually hear him do reads for Captain Dom from the Ralgon Empire. Another one that's really, really unique and interesting is you'll hear Veronica Taylor, who was cast as Shia Haas in the final version of the show. She actually did reads for Yuriko Star. It's very interesting to see, if you're a big Tylor fan, to kind of see what, like a kind of a what if, you know, this actress or this actor had been cast as this character.
Captain Tylor F.
Well, think about it. When you join the military, all your food is free.
Your uniform and daily necessities are all free.
Yuriko A.
I don't mind. We've known each other since we were little. Besides, your father's done so much for the Force. How can United Planets treat him like this?
Don't talk to me like we're friends. Everything went from bad to worse when you showed up. Just relax and leave everything to me. Huh.
There's still so much I want to do. Why do I have to die like this?
Yuriko C.
I don't mind. We've known each other since we were little. Besides, your father's done so much for the Force. How can the United Planets treat him like this? Don't talk to me like we're friends. Everything went from bad to worse when you showed up. Just relax and leave everything to me? Huh. God, there's still so much I want to do. Why do I have to die like this?
One of the other things, too, of interest, at least in regards to Tylor, is that we were able to recover, of course, the original Spanish dub for Irresponsible Captain Tylor and make sure that that finds its way onto the Blu-ray set as well. There was never a Spanish dub recorded for the OVA series, unfortunately, but the Spanish cast did an amazing job with the TV series for the first, you know, the 26 episodes that they had done. And so being able to include that on the Blu-ray is really nice as well. It required a little bit of work to try and make it sync up, of course, because these visuals were updated visuals, remastered visuals from Japan. So the original Spanish dub, of course, was synced to the original TV masters that were received for the show back in the day. But after all said and done, the dub syncs up really well. And I think that at least people who are interested in the Spanish dub or Spanish speaking people will actually appreciate the fact that this dub was able to be included on the final set. And I can play a little clip of it here as well, and something so that you guys can kind of see at least the difference in terms of the scene, in terms of it being presented as Japanese versus English versus the Spanish dub.
Would you guys just zip it?
Captain, we came on board the Soyukaze to fight, not to just sit around.
If you're going to be this weak belly, they're going to kill us for sure.
Exactly. Captain, sir. War is a clash of strength against strength, where ally and enemy give it their best, and only the winner can survive.
But what do you do when the enemy is more powerful, Mr. Yamamoto?
We humans have prey of minds, isn't that right? Without strategy, you can have no tactics. Without tactics, you can have no victory.
しかし、相手の方が実力上だったらどうすんの?
我々人間には優秀な頭脳があるでしょう。戦略なくして戦術なし。戦術なくして勝利なしです。ティレラボコタ!
Escuche, capitán, nosotros estamos a bordo de esta nave porque queremos pelear.
Si el capitán tiene esa manera de pensar tan cobarde, no podemos seguir luchando.
Tienen razón, capitán. En una batalla se enfrentan los poderes de los guerreros. Todos sus hombres darán lo mejor porque el que gana será el que permanezca con vida.
Sí, pero ¿qué tal si el enemigo es más poderoso que tú? En ese caso, ¿qué harías?
A los humanos se nos ocurren las ideas con el cerebro. Podemos usar millones de estrategias. Sin estrategia no se gana, así debe ser.
So it's really, really interesting and exciting to be able to actually include the Spanish dub as well. It was something that we didn't do, I think, when we did the remastered DVDs, but it was nice to be able to try and find a way to salvage it and make it work for the Blu-ray set. So I moved stations really quickly to get over to the Blu-ray authoring station just so that I could kind of show you a sneak peek of the Blu-ray set as it stands currently. Again, everything is kind of still in flux. These discs are mostly finalized at this point, but I just wanted to kind of give you at least a sneak peek or a glimpse of what's to come in store anyway. So what I've got here is the Tylor OVA project. Currently, it's set up with all of its different linkages in terms of its menus and its different extras that are to be included on the disc. As you get into it, you'll see that this is the first OVA disc, actually, which is going to include the first OVA episode, which is the exceptional episode, and it also includes several of the music videos that were included on the original OVA release for the set as well. But I've got the disc set up here. All of the menus work, at least in terms of what they're designed to do. So scene access comes up, brings up the scene access. You've got your extras menu with all of your different links to the music videos. Setup menu to select between the different languages. And then, of course, once you play the show itself, and the show starts playing, and it brings up the opening for the first OVA episode. It has the pop-up menu with all of the settings that you have for languages and scenes as well. So these discs are in a mostly finalized state. Like I said, one of the things that I'm mainly focused on right now is wrapping up the extras disc. And we're also going through, of course, QC and editing on the book and any of the other final materials that need to be included on the disc. And, you know, just kind of an idea of what is coming with this Ultra set. And yeah, you know, otherwise I appreciate you guys, you know, continuing to check these little videos out and, you know, find out what's going on in our little world in terms of the types of work that we do as we're trying to proceed apace through the production process.